okay, when we first moved out to Hawaii, I was really confused about the whole reef safe, reef friendly, what does it mean? And I
had no idea. I didn't even know it was a new law coming out.
Yeah, so I asked him to look into it. And this is what we have for you.
Hi, I'm Jordan.
And I'm Erica.
We're from the Hawaii Vacation Guide. And this is where we help to explain the difference between reef-safe and reef-friendly sunscreen.
And a whole bunch of other stuff, so you can pick the best sunscreen. So when we first moved out to Hawaii, actually even before we moved out here, I was super confused. I had heard that you couldn't use sunscreen that wasn't reef-friendly or reef-safe.
We had no idea what that meant.
And so then I got here and I saw all this sunscreen in the stores, and some was labeled reef-friendly and others wasn't, and I was like, I thought there was a law.
Yeah, and I'm like, oh, can we get a ticket on the beach if we bring the wrong stuff? And we just had no idea what would happen.
And there's signs everywhere to not bring it in, and it was just confusing. Yeah. I didn't know. So Jordan spent some time looking into this because I was like, what do we buy? Can we buy this stuff from Costco? Because it's really a good deal and I'd like to buy it.
And I got deep into the research. I had fun. I mean, I'm a chemical engineer, but you don't have to be a chemical engineer to understand it, but there are some really big words and chemicals on the back of sunscreen.
He's a nerd.
Yeah, so like, so I got really into it to the point where now I wear sun shirts when I go out, like UV protection shirts instead of wearing sunscreen. So it definitely changed my mindset about sunscreen.
Yeah, when you remember.
When I remember, yeah. That's important. Henry's always wearing it though.
He is.
Sunscreen law. Okay, so passed in 2018, it goes into effect January 1st, 2021. And the law is that they won't be able to distribute or sell sunscreen that contains two chemicals, oxybenzone and octinoxate. Tough ones to say, but that's essentially it right there. They're just not allowed to sell them. Why? All right, good question. That's what we're wondering too. So they passed this law based on a study that was done. And what they did was they took those two chemicals and they grew coral with it, right? So baby coral. And what they found was that it causes coral bleaching, which doesn't kill the coral, but like it opens up for disease and all these other problems. And then also it can even affect the DNA, or it damages the DNA of baby coral. So it's pretty serious.
Indirectly kills the coral.
Yeah, exactly. Indirectly kills it.
And if we kill the coral, no more fish for you to see out here when you go snorkeling.
Yeah. And the Hawaii reefs have actually been like deteriorating for the last few decades. So when the study come out, people are like, aha, we got smoking. Yeah. Now there's other things that hurt the reefs too, not just sunscreen, like warming water temperatures, pollution, all those types of things also do it. But this one is something that we can prevent, right? Or control a little better.
Yeah.
So my main four takeaways from the law are this. First is that you won't be able to buy the sunscreen here in Hawaii. Number two, you can still bring it from the mainland, but you probably really shouldn't because it was found to hurt the reefs. Number three is that you can still use that sunscreen if you have a doctor's prescription for it. And then number four is you can't get a ticket if you're using the wrong sunscreen on the beach. Like if you bring some from the mainland,
you cannot
get a ticket. They're not going to be out there trying to enforce this. It's really just about preventing the sale of it here in Hawaii.
You probably will get some people mad at you though.
If they notice what kind of sunscreen you have. Yeah, but I'm sure after 2021, you'd be able to look at the sunscreens and be like, that's the one that's not legal anymore.
Yeah. This is pretty gross. When he told me this, I was disgusted. But the amount of sunscreen that gets in the water every single year.
Yeah, because when we heard about the sunscreen, I was like, really? How much sunscreen actually gets in the water?
It soaks in, right?
Yes, it's in your skin. It's actually quite a lot, right? So the National Park Service estimates 6,000 tons of sunscreen ends up in the reef every year. And then Hawaii alone, in Hanama Bay, which is the busiest bay in Hawaii, that's 2,600 daily swimmers. And then I found that's 412 pounds of sunscreen a day. 412 pounds of sunscreen, that's just one bay. Here we are in Apili Bay, it's March, the weather's beautiful, and there's already a few hundred people here on the beach. So you gotta assume throughout the day, you're gonna get over 1,000 swimmers in this beach alone in Maui. So there you go, you got about 300 pounds of sunscreen ending up in this beautiful bay just today.
All right, but I was super confused because I had read only buy reef-safe sunscreen, and then we go to stores and I only see labels for reef-friendly. So
what's the difference? Thanks for asking.
You're welcome.
So yeah, so this whole new reef-safe rule is too new. So the FDA is the one who set standards for this stuff. So like the FDA is the one who said you can't have waterproof sunscreen anymore, you can only have water-resistant sunscreen. So the FDA needs to weigh in on this. So right now, reef-friendly and reef-safe are synonyms.
Are they?
Yeah, so there's like no difference because no one's setting a standard for it. So whatever what the brand wants to say. So after doing this research though, what I found is reef-friendly is probably a better term because reef-safe to me, like safe means like it won't harm it, it won't cause any damage. And really, they don't know yet what the full impact of sunscreen is. These two chemicals that they banned are only the first two they studied. There's 6-8 other chemicals in sunscreen. They're chemical filters.
Yeah.
And they're gonna start studying those also. So that's why when you're in Hawaii, like here in Maui, they have all these signs up for environmental activists listing like all these big chemicals, like these big names. And they're not illegal yet, but they're gonna start doing studies. But these environmental advocates are like, look, these two are bad.
Mm-hmm.
These other six are probably bad too. So just stay away from them. That's what they're saying.
So what's the deal with spray on sunscreen? Because there are signs everywhere that tell you not to spray sunscreen on the beach.
And then another little thing you can do is avoid using the spray on sunscreens when you're on the beach. Just because when you spray, some gets on you, but most of it gets on the beach and then it washes into the ocean, right? And that's what they want to try to avoid.
Which I totally didn't realize until he said it. And then I was like, oh my God, that's so true. When I spray my sunscreen on, it's just going everywhere.
Everywhere.
Okay, so where does that leave you? Does that leave you getting skin cancer out here?
No.
So we have 7 tips to protect yourself and protect the little baby coral that are here.
Yeah, totally. Because, I mean, we still have sunscreen in our drawer that's baby-friendly, but it's not reef-friendly. So, yeah, stuff that's in the drawer is oxybenzone in it. Mm-hmm.
Henry doesn't go in the ocean, really.
That's a good reason. Tip number one is wear UV protection clothing. Wear your sun shirts when you go out. It's kind of like the best way is just to avoid sunscreen altogether.
So, Henry, if we put this sun shirt on, we don't need to put sunscreen on your arms or your chest, okay?
So you can buy UV shirts, wear hats, wear long sleeve stuff. For babies, it's great to do. And actually, I read a Consumer Reports study, and they found just wearing a white t-shirt is almost as good, if not better, than some UV protection clothing.
What?
Even when it's wet.
What?
Yeah, so they're not even pushing for UV protection clothing. They're like, just wear a white t-shirt. Mm-hmm.
Well,
so yeah, don't overthink it. Yeah, I know.
Okay, but we still have to put it on your face, okay?
Okay, tip number two, use non-nano lotions. Non-nano. So we're gonna talk about mineral-safe sunscreen soon, but the problem with mineral-based sunscreens is that like it leaves a white mark, like the zinc on your nose, the famous zinc mark, and a lot of people don't like that. So what manufacturers have done is they've created nano-based ones, but the problem is that nano compound is now can get into the reefs and they believe it'll cause damage too because it's so small, it'll sun grow. So we'll say right on the label, non-nano. So especially if you're buying like a mineral-based sunscreen, look for non-nano on there. That's the best one to use.
There's a lot to remember.
Tip number three, avoid sunscreens that have ingredients listed as oxybenzone or octinoxate. Those are the two illegal in Hawaii. Also, the Key West, Florida made it illegal too. But yeah, it'll say right on the label what active ingredients are in there, so avoid those two.
Luckily, they make reef-friendly spray sunscreens because we love spray sunscreen. It's just so easy, it's much better. But you don't want to spray it at the beach because as you spray, right, things go all over. So a lot of sunscreen ends up washing into the ocean. So that's why they recommend you spray at home and then bring your rub-on sunscreen to reapply when you're at the beach.
Number five is, once again, check the label. Look for paraben-free lotions. Some manufacturers use paraben as a preservative. What they found is butylparaben can cause coral reef bleaching and then also has some other side effects with humans. So a lot of manufacturers have already stopped using butylparaben, but you'll see paraben-free listed on the label.
I see that a lot.
So number six, get water-resistant sunscreen. Go for the max of 80 minutes. There's usually 40 minutes and 80 minutes. Go for the 80-minute one.
Wow.
The longer you're in the water, it's better for you, but also less sunscreen gets on the coral, right?
Sure.
It's not coming off yet. Okay, so number seven, use mineral-based sunscreens. These minerals are zinc oxide or titanium oxide, and these are the ones that they believe are probably the best for coral reefs. So it'll say right on there is active ingredients. Just once again, use non-nano ones. And besides that, though, those are probably the best ones to use, besides wearing UV protection clothing.
Okay, so if you're like me and you're like, cool, just tell me what to buy and I'll get it.
Yeah.
We've got a list for you.
Yes.
So Jordan has done the research. He has a list of all the best sunscreens.
21 of them.
We've tried a lot of them.
Yes.
We use a lot of them. I'm leaning on him and all the research he's done. And you can too. So head to thehawaiivacationguide.com/sunscreen to get your list.
Yeah, that's the best way to do it. And then we'll tell you all the sunscreens that you can buy out there.
Okay, thanks for watching. And thank you for keeping the reefs safe out here, or being friendly to the reefs.
That's it, right. Yeah, reef-friendly, not reef-safe.
And we have a lot of other videos that aren't so focused on sunscreen, but are focused on Hawaii. So if you are looking for itineraries, guides, best of, make sure you hit subscribe and like, and come back here every Friday, because this guy publishes a new video every single week.
We have a lot of fun with these.